So here we focus on the introductions of curves and the polygons. So now here our topic is plane curve. So as you know that paper is a model for a plane surface. When you join a number of points without lifting a pencil from the paper, you get a plane curve. So what is the meaning of that? So meaning is quite simple. Here we assume you are having one paper. So as you know, the paper, it is nothing but a plane surface area. Okay, it is just like table, means the surface is exactly plane and you can draw there any curve without lifting the pencil. Suppose I am drawing shape, you can draw any shape without lifting the pencil. Okay, so whatever the shape is there, you can easily draw there. So that shape is known as a plane curve. Means you can draw the rectangle, triangle, quadrilateral, any shape, polygon also. So that is what the plane curve. So types of curve. Open curve. Open curve doesn't enclose any area within itself and it has two end points. So this is the type of curve. So here in this example of open curve, this is what your starting point and that is what your ending point. So here clearly you observe, here also starting point and this is what the ending point, here also starting and the ending point. So whatever the figures are there, like this one also the example of curve. So that is what starting and ending point, they doesn't meet each other. So this is what the open curve. Close curve. Close curve diagram, it's very simple friend. Whatever the start point is there, that is also the ending point. Suppose here one point is there. So this is the curve that you are drawing and it will meet to the same point. So what is the explanation? Closed curve has no end point and enclose the area. It is formed by joining the end point of open curve together. Means what I told you, whatever the point is there, when you draw the curve, that point itself is a starting and ending point and it will be closed. It will just close the surface. Here also it will close, here also it will close. So circle, rectangle, quadrilateral, polygon, whatever the shape you draw, they belong to that category of closed curve. Next one is a simple curve. Simple curve changes direction but doesn't cross itself while changing the direction. Simple curve can be open and the closed both. This is exactly the simple curve. The point of the simple curve is very simple. It doesn't cross itself. It doesn't cross itself means what? For example, I am drawing here one curve like that. So it is crossing at this point. So that is not the simple curve. You observe both. This is the closed curve but simple. This is open but simple because they are not crossing itself. They are not, these two means part. Here whatever the curve you are drawing, they are not crossing. Okay, so that is what the simple curve. Non-simple curve means that crosses its own path is called non-simple curve. This is not simple open curve and this is not simple closed curve. Why it is open? Because this portion is remain open. Here both the portion after crossing close. So this is not simple but closed, not simple but open. So these types, if you understood, then you can easily solve the question on the basis of that. So here match the following one question I put here. So what you think about the first one? As you know, this is the simple curve but it is not closed. A closed curve, exactly it is not closed, it is open. Simple curve, that is not closed, so it belongs to the C. Okay, it is a simple curve and at the same time it is not closed. So here I simply draw one line, so because it match with the C. Then second one, in the second one, as you know, it is the close because that area is closed. But what about the upper area? It is not closed. This area is closed but this area is not closed, so it is belonging to the open category and in the open category it is not simple. So here it is not a simple curve. Again, the other options are like It is a closed curve that is not simple, but it is not closed. Simple closed, it is not belonging to the simple closed curve. In exactly, it is not a simple curve, so it is belonging to this part. So here the first answer you can say it is C. And what about the answer of this? It is D. Next one is third one. Third one, as you know, it is a simple closed curve because that portion is closed. So here its answer is A. Fourth one is a closed curve, but it is not simple. So closed curve, that is not simple. The answer is B. So if you understand the presentation, then you can easily solve that. Interior and exterior part of the closed curve. So both are the closed curve. This is the interior part and this is the exterior part, means outside the curve and inside the curve. Simple closed curve. Now we will see polygon. So simple closed curve made up of only line segment. This point is important. It consists of line segment. Segment means particular length will be there. So it consists of line segment and is called a polygon. So you can observe here both the diagram. This is what the closed curve that are polygon, because it is the closed and it consists of line segment. Here it consists of line segment, but they are open, they are not totally closed. So this is not the polygon and this is the example of polygons. So classification of polygon, because in polygon some types are there, like if suppose number of side or vertices. Number of side means this is one side, this is second, third. And vertices, one point, second point, third point. So here this is what the triangle, because three sides are there. Quadrilateral, if the four sides are there. Pentagon, five side. Hexagon, six side. Heptagon means seven side that we rarely use. Octagon, eight sides are there. Nonagon, here nine sides are there that we rarely use. So if the, you can say, except triangle, means suppose odd number of sides are there that we rarely use, except the triangle. So decagon, 10 sides are there up to n. So these are the types of the polygon, and most of the time we refer the triangle. Quadrilateral is very important. We refer hexagon in most of the example. So these types we generally use. Then diagonals. Diagonal is a line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertices of polygon. So this is what the you can say quadrilateral. It belonging to the category of polygon, that is itself the polygon. And in the polygon category, as it is looking like rectangle. Okay, this is what the rectangle. In the case of, you can say, whatever the polygon is there or whatever the quadrilaterals are there, so there you may have the diagonal. Diagonal is a line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertices, means this is not the diagonal. PQ is not a diagonal. Okay, and this is the side, this is also the not diagonal, but it is connecting to that non-consecutive vertices, so that is exactly the diagonal. This is also diagonal. Next one is a convex and concave polygon. So this is what the convex and this is concave. Now here in the convex and concave, one difference is there that you can clearly observe. In the case of convex, that inner part you see, in that inner part each angle it is less than 180. This angle also it is not in straight line, so 180. This angle it is 90 degree, this is also 90, it is less than 90, here it is less than 180, so every angle is less than 180. But in the case of concave, if you see this inner angle, okay, here suppose here you see the angle carefully, so this is more than 180. This angle you observe, it is also more than 180. This angle you observe, more than 180. Again in this diagram, this angle is more than 180. So this is what concave. But here all the inner angles, suppose I consider this one less than 180, here it's 90, so it is less than 180. This angle less than 180 means every diagram less than 180. So that is the difference between convex and concave. So in the case of convex polygon, the polygon is less than 180. So this is the example of the convex polygon. Concave polygon is again, it is more than 180. You clearly see this diagram, more than 180 angle is there. This angle is more than 180. Here this angle is more than 180. So it is what? Concave polygon. Regular and irregular polygon. So regular polygon means it belong to the equiangular and equilateral. Means they are all sides same and all angles same. That is what the concept of regular polygon. This is the example. Their sides are exactly same. Angles are also same. Here in the case of square, their sides are same. Angles are same. This is the equilateral triangle, so they are belonging to the regular polygons. Irregular polygons means either their sides are different or angles are different. In the case of that first diagram, this is different angle, this is different angle, this is different. Here also this side measurement is different, this is also different. Even though their angles are same, but their sides not matching, all the sides not same. So that is the example of irregular polygons. Angle-sum property. So here the concept is very simple. In the angle-sum property, if you draw triangle, so addition of all these three angle, it is 180. And if you draw any quadrilateral like square, rectangle, the addition of this all four angle will be 360 degree. We will see in this diagram, this is what? One triangle, this is second triangle. So true triangle consists of one quadrilateral. Okay, so one triangle measurement is 180, second triangle measurement is 180. So 180 plus 180 is 360. That's why the quadrilateral consists of 360 degree angle measurement. So here I am giving the proof also. ABCD is a quadrilateral and we have to prove each side addition is equal to 360 degree. So in the proof, first, as I told you, it's an addition of two triangle where one triangle consists of 180. So in the case of triangle ADC, you have here in the diagram point of view, measurement of D is X and measurement of here, measurement of angle D is X and then measurement of angle D, A and C. So this measurement is Y. Okay, if you see D, C and A, this measurement is Z. So now finally you do their addition, it will come 180 because of sum of all angles of triangle is 180. Now in the second triangle, if you go there also, same thing is there. Three angles, three measurement, their angle sum is 180 because of sum of angles of triangle is 180. Finally, you have to add 1 and 2. So it means X plus Y plus Z and here A plus B plus C equal to 180 plus 180. Now when you solve that, here as you know in the diagram, Y plus B is nothing but A and Z plus C is nothing but C. So you come closer that values. So Y plus B, you make a bunch of that, then Z plus C. Why we are doing this? Because from figure, X is nothing but D, Y plus B is A, Z plus C is C, and this A is nothing but B. So finally, putting this above value in equation 3, means this angle, means in place of that you have to write the angle, in place of that measurement. So angle D is for, the measurement of D is X, okay. So in place of that X you have to write D. Y plus B is nothing but A, and what about the C? It is Z plus C. So you write C, and D in place of that, this A, you have to write D. So then it is what? 360. Hence we prove that. So you just practice that theorem, and I hope friend you understood this presentation. Thanks for watching. Thank you.